Yeah! Welcome, welcome, welcome to the TMF podcast. What's up? What's up? Listen, what's up? I'm here. I'm your host, T Staples, and I'm joined today by.
Girl, Alona Boo.
Alona Boo in the building.
In the house because it's cold as hell outside.
Yeah, look, for all y'all watching, listening out there, we're bringing you all these messages from my mouth to your mind. So if you feel our show, show us how you feel by subscribing. That's right. Hit that little bell if you're on YouTube. If you're on Instagram, we ain't on here for long. It's only going to be an hour long. We ain't on here for long. That's all you're getting. You know what I'm saying? And don't forget, though, to send us a message. Our handles are in the description below. Please let us know how you feel. In today's episode, we're going to be talking about. She's back again, y'all. Brittany Renner. Brittany Renner is back again. Okay, I'm sorry. I had to do that. And then, listen, I'm telling y'all, man. She's burning up the charts, man. She's coming back, burning the charts up for y'all. So listen, we're gonna chat about it. She went to Jackson State University to talk to the football team about the game. But before we go there, I cannot overlook that we just had an epic versus battle. Well, I don't know. Would you call it epic versus battle between. Boom, 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 and 3-6 Mafia. And it got wild, y'all. It got real wild. Hold on, let me pull my notes up. I got notes on this. Let me pull my notes up. Oh, my notes is up here. Pfft, I put them in the wrong part of the screen. I'm like, where are my notes at? It got wild, y'all. What's crazy is, you know, when you see these versus battles, right, it's supposed to kind of like, I don't know, like, kind of jerk the senses, the nostalgia sense, right? The your sense of like, oh my God, I remember when.
That's the whole thing.
I remember when sense. That's what it's pulling on your heartstrings of time gone by, but just give you that feeling of remembering. But sometimes, and I'm gonna pull a video. Let me add this to the stream real quick. You know, it's gonna try to play first, but I'm adding to the stream. Here, I got the little sample of the broadcast. And I want to add to the stream this little thing because I want y'all, some of this stuff to be getting wild on here. It was this one little spot where, in the beginning, I was reminded that Bone Thugs and Harmony, well, we forgot about the thug part. Because they don't be playing. I think this is their first song. So they flipped the quarter. So they end up being the ones that are going to go last after you know, after everything got said and done. And so of course 3-6 went first and recognize, I don't know if this was even, in my opinion, a proper matchup per se. I mean maybe I'm not saying that right, but if you watched it, it was like they had a lot of smooth, chill, kind of laid back, you know, stuff that was happening. But Bone Thugs is really some thugs, man. Hold on, let me see. I think this is the part. Let me see. He flipped the coin here. I want to get to this part when they did their first song. Toward the end of their first song, I just got real like reminded that they were who they were. See Busy right there. So wait a minute, do you know all the thugs? Do you know all the bones?
There is.
Can you name them all?
Let me see. There's
okay on this picture. From are you going from right to left or left to right?
Oh, I can't. Like point of no, I can't point. Okay, hold on. Let me think. Let me get close up on it so I can see who it is. I think the one. Shit. let me just name.
Wait a minute. Do you want?
So there's Busy Bone.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Let me. Do you want me? Let me get back in here. Let me see if I can. I'm gonna full screen this for you. Boom. Okay. Now, can you see him? Does that help?
Yeah, that help a little bit. I'm just okay. Trying to. Okay, so I know there's Busy Bone.
Mm-hmm.
There is, ain't there a Lazy Bone?
There's a Lazy Bone. Mm-hmm.
I know there's Wishbone, right?
Mm-hmm. All right, you almost there. Two more.
Crazy Bone.
Yep. One more.
Crazy Bone and shit. What is the last one's name? Damn, I can't think of the last one's name.
Flesh and Bone.
That's right.
Busy Bone, Crazy Bone, Lazy Bone, Wishbone, Flesh and Bone.
Flesh and Bone, yeah.
As you can see, they came out for the verses. They was out there. They was out there. But we were reminded, let me go back to my, no, that ain't what I want. I want this one right here. Boom. Yeah. We were reminded that they are not just thugs. They're not just Bone in Harmony. They're Bone Thugs in Harmony. And let's see. I'm just gonna get right to the point. Now, first of all, I don't even know what they were talking about right there. Just be honest with you. There was a lot of stuff.
No, I wasn't familiar with that song.
I wasn't familiar with a lot of they. I felt bad because I felt like I grew up with them, but maybe I didn't. So I was like, I don't know. Oh, see, right? They talking about killing them. And watch this right here. I'm about to turn the blue suits red, so you know what that means. You know what that means, Alona. Look at Crazy Bone right there. Still looking crazy. I think this is crazy as hell when I saw this. Now it's going to get real offensive real quick. Watch this. It got rough real quick. So damn niggas is thugs for real. I ain't never heard nobody put that much gunshot in the song. Pop, 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 pop. So yeah, that I do remember them now. Yes. They did pull on my nostalgia strings there. Okay, so about 20 minutes into this, we get to a moment where things just get a little ratchet too quick. And what happened was, I think Busy, I guess he forgot what the point of them being there was. But here we go. I'm going to play this little piece right here for y'all, just so y'all can see what happened. I don't know this song either, by the way. Hold on. Oh my God. Alright, watch Beezy.
Hey, before we even get started, you ugly motherfuckers ain't finna be mocking me while I'm on motherfucking stage. Like, straight the fuck up.
Nigga, suck my dick.
And Gangsta Boo.
Suck my dick.
And so they had to zoom the camera out right here.
Busy Bone, a hater. Sissy ass nigga, what the fuck wrong with you?
She said, Busy Bone, a hater.
Why y'all do this shit, man?
Why y'all do this shit? Okay, so I'm not gonna stay on that too long. There was some more shit talking back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
It kept going. And what's crazy is, at least from my opinion, what I thought was just insane was we are grown. Like we are like we too grown for this, y'all. Like, come
way,
on, bro.
Way too grown. Like
we here to celebrate both of y'all.
Exactly.
This is a celebration. This ain't about motherfuckers coming
this
to shoot.
This is not East Coast West Coast rivalry right now. This is we done been there, done that. This is not Pac and Biggie. Like y'all, both of y'all.
Right, we lost Pac and Biggie. That should be enough.
Right, like both of y'all can sit the fuck down because you know what I'm saying, like ain't neither one of y'all in heavy rotation right now. So don't be popping off like your shit is jumping right now.
Like your shit is jumping, jumping. Ladies, do you hear?
No, but that was funny. But how you gonna throw the mic and run though? That's what was funny.
and left his boys there to fight.
Right, and then
left his boys there to fight.
Though that was funny.
Man, that shit was crazy. Okay, so you see what's happening. Okay, so let me go back. How I get back? Boom. Okay, so then of course I skipped through a little bit because I think they got back started. They end up having to do a commercial break. Mm-hmm. The whole nine, talking about the due to technical difficulties, which I don't think you can blame that on technical difficulties. That's just due to human difficulties.
No, that's.
They end up getting the show back popping. And I forget what was said. I'm going to play it because I don't know if they say it right around the time where they start when the show got back popping. Let me see. I think it got about 4 or 5 minutes later. They finally got it back together. Let me see if it plays.
Say hell yeah!
DJ Felly Fell.
We having a good time and people paying money to see a legendary show.
First of all, she said we having a good time and people paid money to see a legendary show. Up at that point, y'all wouldn't have a good time. But I mean, I'm gonna let y'all go. So what ended up happening was they started doing another set and, you know, doing their music. You know. Notice this picture. What do you see? It looks different than where we first started.
What the hell is that?
I'll tell you what you see that's different. It was five people up there. Now it's four.
Right. Yeah. I see he's not there, but what's that thing behind him?
That's probably the set. Something like Notorious B.I.G. or something like that it says. It's Tombstone up there. So what, the Tombstone?
Yeah. Oh, is that what that is? A Tombstone? It's,
yeah, Tombstone, Notorious B.I.G.
Busy was blocking it the first time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, you know, he's not there. So right. Maybe about another 15, 20 minutes. I guess he cools down. He finally comes back. Busy Bone comes back to the stage. And he's not rapping, but he's just kind of hanging out. And then he starts to rap. So it took him about 20 minutes. It says he came back to the stage. He apologized, matter of fact, which was crazy. But the fact that it even happened is insane to me. Like, don't y'all, were y'all talking backstage?
Right.
Like, I'm not understanding why there was a need for him to come back to the stage to apologize when basically he just disrespected the whole reason why everybody's, you know what I mean? I don't know what they're doing back there.
You really swear,
listen,
I'm
a easy.
Now, I didn't know Easy E brought them out too, but they said that as well. Easy E's the reason why they even came out. You should see him come out in a second.
Gotta get that paper.
And some of these songs be entered in odd places too.
Yeah. Hey man.
So notice how when they perform, how 3-6 was going far away. You know what I mean? Make sure they gave them plenty of space on the stage. But there is Busy coming out to mend it.
DJ Felly Fell.
That was weird.
I want to apologize to everybody the fuck out there on both sides. I'm not trying to fuck this shit up. Pardon me. Let's keep the party motherfucking going.
Pardon me. Pardon my ignorant ass. Pardon my ignorance.
Right.
And the night didn't end there. That wasn't the only night. They had a real technical difficulty in the middle of one of the sets for 3-6 Mafia. I thought this shit was fucking hilarious. I was just watching it and I thought something was wrong with my screen.
Liquor, drugs, smoking weed, trying to get a paycheck.
And this is one of their popular songs right here.
A girl either keep that pussy wet so I can get paid and relax in the shade and say fuck a 9 to 5 cause a nigga tired of slaves never easy for a player in the hood. On the come up, if I meet a gal with three, get some more, she get done. Ever since I can remember, I've been popping my collar.
You the crowd,
that
boy.
Us, nigga, that wasn't us,
oh,
nigga. That wasn't us.
Technical difficulty.
Somebody hide the ball.
Technical difficulty. We ain't had nothing to do with that shit, man.
Hey, hey,
we ain't do that.
Hey, we did that just to get views. That's going to be the shit they play tomorrow.
I know.
That nigga, they, how on popping my collar, your song going to skip, bruh?
Right.
That's your song. Hey. I don't know. They, that DJ might have just got punished. I just let you know that. That was not a good moment for that DJ.
No, it was not.
That was one of the big songs.
Like,
how yeah. But what was cool about the night, they had some other big moments, and I won't belabor the point. You know, they had Lil Wayne come out. They had Lil Jon come out. They had a lot of features. Terrence Howard came out to do Hard Out Here for a Pimp.
If Taraji could have been there though, but I know she was doing Annie that night, so
that would have been fire.
Yeah,
that would have been fire. If they could have had Taraji pop out and what?
And say that part. Yeah.
Man, what you said, that would have been fire. You know what I mean? So I don't know. But it was a cool situation, you know what I'm saying? And I had a good time watching it. I realized from watching the stream that essentially, I remember the songs, but I don't think I knew any of the lyrics other than like some of like the easy ones of the Bone songs, you know, like, and I'm gonna miss everybody, and I'm gonna miss
to rap a Bone right. harmony song, you know what I'm
right.
saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's
right.
They rap really fast, and then it's harmonious. But you know what I'm saying? But you just
I can sing it. Yeah, I can sing it.
Right. Like, Crossroads is about the only one I know some parts. I'd be like, oh, and I'm going to miss everybody.
Yeah. Right. Everybody. I got that.
We got
but I realized,
that
thing, man, they be snapping on their stuff, and I need to go back and look at some of the lyrics. Like, I don't even know what they were saying in some of these songs.
Because it's hard to understand what they're saying sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I'd just be like, no.
Shimmy up out of booty sky. You know, whoop de whoop de whoop de whoop de scoop. Like, I don't know what them niggas saying.
I don't even know what they be saying, but it sounds good, but I don't know what they're
saying. It sounds really good. They got that music. And what I noticed, and I kind of think that this battle was a little bit imbalanced. It was mismatched because, and I don't know if it's fair. I know they do have some type of rivalry because they both groups, but it just seemed weird to have 3-6, who made arguably a lot of shit we used to listen to the club.
It's like club hits versus like more like reality every day, you know, like hip hop and telling stories and shit, because both of them are like some storytellers, you know what I'm saying? So two different types of hip hop
of right stuff. There. Right. And that's exactly what I was feeling. I was feeling that it was not exactly the same kind of. And so then when you're making comparisons, it almost seems like. And maybe you have to make a comparison of lyrics to beats, basically, in that case. You know what I mean? Because even, I don't know if that was Crazy Bone that said it. At one point, he was like, I know y'all got the beats. We need to get one of them beats from y'all. Because they did. They had some songs. Bit, ho, ho, ho. Like, they just had some songs that just came on. You just like, oh, yeah, that's that club. And it makes you dance and make you excited. But, it was some stuff that Bone Thugs and Harmony, it just was like introspective. It made me think. I was like, yeah, man, I remember this one. It was smooth. Like, I'm trying to think of.
Yeah, theirs is a little bit more smooth.
It's
a little bit more hype.
It's hype. Like, okay, real talk. I kind of felt like, and this may be wrong to put them in this category, I kind of feel like I would only play them at a funeral. Like, after a funeral, we had to repass. Yeah. I'll put that on at the repass. You know, like,
you're stupid.
I really feel that way. I just, not I don't know how you feel. Put that in. Yeah, you put Bone Thugs on. That's, that made me feel good. You made me want to pull one out. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. I mean, like I said, it's introspective.
Every day,
a lot of
every
times,
day,
so.
Every day, every day.
Yeah. Yeah. So you can definitely play Crossroads at the Repass. I would not be mad.
Yeah. Now the song they had with Lil Jon, that was a hitter. That was a hitter. So I had to give him that. But yeah, I don't know. It was team mismatch. And so a lot of people, hands down, gave it a 3-6, of course, because, you know.
Because they had the club bangers.
They had the bangers, and then they didn't start no fights, and they arguably brought out bigger, because Bone brought out some people, but they 3-6 brought out bigger acts. I don't know. Lil Wayne versus Lil Jon. I'm two big acts right there, so.
Yeah.
I don't know. tell us what you think in the description. Comment below. Who do you think won the verses? Who do you like more? I mean, do you just have a preference? Like, who would you play Bone Thugs at the funeral in the Repass? Because I would put him on the Repass. Would y'all put him? Let us know. You know, put it in the comments below. We here to debate. Okay, so let's get to the topic of today. I am going to start off the topic of today with a little bit of a clip. Do y'all, well, I guess I could do this. Instead of the clip, I'll do this. Do y'all remember Brittany Renner and the situation she just was in just recently when she kind of blew up with her whole circumstances with PJ Washington? Hold on, let me give y'all a little reminder. Yeah, this is her and PJ Washington. This is the, what do you call these pictures? These are the
maternity shoot
pictures. All right. And she was talking about essentially, you know, this is the guy that she had a baby with. Now, before this baby, there was a video she did before she got with PJ that talked about what her thoughts were on athletes. I'm gonna play this real quick so y'all can hear this.
First people to deal with are the athletes. None of them use condoms, really. So if y'all really want to try to come up off a check off a man, I mean, you could just fuck an athlete. They're really dumb.
That is. You could just fuck an athlete. They're really dumb. She did fuck an athlete, and she got pregnant. So part of her plan worked. Part of her plan worked.
Or was it her plan? We don't officially know.
Right.
Allegedly,
but it seems like it was her plan based on what she's told us publicly.
If you look at that video and then look at the fact that she got pregnant by an athlete, it looks like it was a plan.
Well, she told us also in an interview with Kevin Samuels, which we played some of the clips a few episodes back if y'all want to go watch. The episode, the interview with Kevin Samuels, and you should go watch the interview. It's on his channel. It's called When Doves Cry. I guess she was a dove. But, you know, when Doves Cry's interview, she talked about saying that she thought that PJ Washington was going to be her guy.
Yeah.
That was it for her. And so, like Alona Boo said, even though this video existed prior to all this other information, it seems as though she has told her audience, if you want to get that bag, athletes are dumb, get their ass, right?
Yep.
And the problem is that she really didn't tell the audience a whole lot of the truth about what comes with that, which is a little stress, a little trauma. Mm-hmm. In that, yes, if you do this, you also may be kind of left in a bad position. And before we get to talking about why it's important that, you know, or what the whole situation of her being brought to Jackson State to talk to their team, we have to preface that she has gone through this thing. So I got another clip for you guys. It's a little short clip here. Well, it's a little longer than the last one. It's a lot longer than the last one. I'm sorry. I shouldn't lie to y'all like that. But I want y'all to pay attention to this clip. This is, she's made the statement about getting pregnant by athletes. She found an athlete. They hooked up. They had unprotected sex. She got pregnant, has the baby. And now she has found out that this man has not been who he said he is or wants to do what she thought he was going to do with them as a family. This is after the fact. Listen to this.
Oh, moved into my new place today. Y'all, when I tell you, I've been thugging, okay? Like, been living with my mom and my sister. It's me, my mom, my sister, my baby. I mean, because, you know, I 2.5 months when I decided to leave, my baby was 2.5 months old. I didn't have anywhere to go. I didn't even have a car. I still don't have a car. I got rid of my car, you know, because, you know, empty promises, whatever. But I've been thinking so hard, bitch. This has really been the hardest time of my life. And here I am. Because I thought somebody, right. Because, yeah. That to say, don't ever relinquish your independence for a relationship. Follow your dreams, not your boyfriend. A man is not a financial plan. Always have your own things. I honestly feel like since this situation, I don't think, even if I was married, I can't see myself not having my own house outside of the main house. Like, I would just have that in my own space. Maybe that will change with time, who knows. But also, it's crazy. Like, people, they want to see you fail. Oh, they want to see you fail. When you don't, oh, they have no control over you. They can't do anything because all you fucking do is win. Like, God, this girl's still here? Because I thought somebody thought that was good. Yeah, I thought. You thought. We all thought. I want to say thank you to the people on all social media platforms that continue. God, don't cry. That continue to support me, because this shit's a fucking privilege to have. I'm so fucking thankful. I swear to God, I see the world with a whole different set of eyes now. I really do. Thank you for the people who continue to support me despite the fuckery that I've had to endure after being lied on. Thank you to my real friends and my family that aren't yes men, that have my fucking back. Because that's about the only reason I have some of my sanity. Just thank you. And thank you to the universe for redirection. Thank God I didn't get what I thought I wanted. Because, okay, I'll take a few months of disappointment over a lifetime of disappointment. I forgot to add. Leave after the first lie. You know, people can change, but they rarely do. When people are lying about what they're lying about, ain't no fixing that. Ain't no coming back from that, bro. That's how you rockin'. If that's how you rockin', I ain't rollin'. Last thing. A lot of people are afraid to leave relationships. Fear of missing out. Like, oh, I built this person up. You know, no one else is gonna reap the benefits. I don't want to start over. I'm scared. Oh my God, who's going to want me? Especially as a mom. Because, you know, fucking moms, we're just shamed for everything. No one's going to want to be with you to have a kid, you know? There's just fear of leaving. Fear of just looking stupid. The only time you look stupid is when you allow yourself to look stupid. You don't look stupid when something doesn't work out. And bitch, you've had enough. This doesn't work for me. We are not a match. We are not a vibrational match. And I'm going to be on my way. If anything, I'm smart, bitch. Because I don't have time to waste. My energy is sacred and I treat it as such.
You saw it here first. Or last. Or second. I don't know. But just to remind you.
The people to deal with are the athletes. None of them use condoms, really. So if y'all really want to try to come up off a check off a man, I mean, you could just fucking athlete. They're really dumb.
Kind of a contradictory statement. But now that you've seen the aftermath, what do you think, Alona Boo, after watching The Fall? What do you think?
I think, put it like this. If the videos were really shot in chronological order, where mm-hmm. she made that first video saying, you know, athletes are dumb. You want to come up on a check, you know what I'm mm-hmm. saying? And then she, you know, gets an athlete, gets pregnant. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, all that happens. So before I finish my statement, let me say, I did, you know, read a couple of stories about the situation. Mm-hmm. And PJ, you know, felt like he was bamboozled, felt like she never really cared for him. Her affection was fake, and it was just all about a check. After everything ended. So, but she, contrary to what he says, she says that, you know, none of that is true, that the whole baby was planned, and that, you know, she told him that I can wait. Like, I don't have to get pregnant right now. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we have time or whatever like that. But he was more pressed. Oh, yeah, go ahead and have my baby. And some dudes do that. So I ain't saying she lying. I ain't saying he lying, because it's her story. It's his story. And then somewhere in the middle is truth.
Is the story. Right.
Right. Somewhere in the middle is truth. So if I take a little bit of what he said and a little bit of what she said, and then we look at these videos, go back to being in chronological order, what it looks like to me, of course, not being in the situation, not knowing 100% of whatever is going on, but it looks like, okay, this is the initial attitude of a young girl. You know, I want to get that bag. I want to get that check. So I'm going to go ahead. You know what I'm saying? I got the look. I'm
right.
I got, right, you know what I'm saying? Bam, bam, bam.
Mm-hmm.
I'm it. They want me. You know what I'm saying? So it goes from that. So I'm going to come up on this check. This is the come up right now. It goes from that to I'm in this situation. It wasn't exactly the come up that I thought it was going to be. And actually, I'm more miserable than I would have been if I never put myself in this damn situation.
Amen, amen.
So,
amen, amen.
If you can, if you want to call, like, from what I can see from one video to the next one, a lot of growth has happened and a lot of eye-opening epiphanies have happened, where you think one thing, you know what I'm saying? We all do this shit. You think one thing as a, you know, when you're young, you know, teenagers, early 20s, you think you got it all figured out. You know the game, you know the rule book, you know what I'm saying? But the reality is, until you're put in certain situations and have to kind of feel your way through and, you know, navigate your way through them situations, you don't really know how you're going to react. You don't know how other people are going to perceive you or your reactions. And, you know, it's like trial and error. So, like, now, hindsight is always 20/20.
Yeah.
So now, having gone through what she's gone through, she's able to look back and be like, you know what? I thought this was the come up. I thought, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, go ahead and get this quick little check or whatever like that. But it ain't working out the way that, you know what I'm saying, that she initially planned. And that happens a lot of times for people in relationships. You know, it may not be, you know, even if you get in a relationship, not for necessarily a come up financially, but you want to come up emotionally. You want to come up in your happiness. You want to, like, we all want something out of a relationship.
You want a spiritual awakening.
Oh, but so you want anything. You know what I'm saying? Like, so we're not all engaging with each other and not expecting something. And it's not a give and take. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I got in a relationship with somebody and I had no expectations of them, I didn't want anything from them, I'd be lying to my damn self.
Right, right.
So, you know what I'm saying? I think, you know what I'm saying, the most, that last video you showed, of her, you know, just kind of saying, you know, don't be scared to leave. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're more stupid if you stay. You know, you're not happy. You're miserable.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I
mean, I agree with what she said. You know, she wasn't giving any bad advice. She's just like, now that I done been through some shit, like, now I see that the grass is not greener on the other side.
Exactly. Exactly.
Basically. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that what we forget is that everybody tries to live their life on social media, but they forget social media really just a big highlight reel anyway.
Highlight reel.
Yeah, because you ain't putting all the bad on there. Like,
no.
One thing you got to respect with her, she put some of her bad on there, but then niggas ain't putting all the bad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You ain't turn around, oh, my shit was green this morning. Let me put that on social. You know what I mean?
Right. Let's
like, you trying to tell people about your best life and all the stuff you should be doing.
Yeah.
So now, just this past week, with all that you know now, Alona Boo, we have a situation where Brittany went to JSU. Now, don't get me wrong. This is her alma mater. This is her at one of the games. This is actually from a post that she made, Hide Your Sons, and people got offended when she made this post. You know, she was going to do her thing. Her, you know, that's a Hide Your Sons look right there. Look like a cheerleader, slick. If you know anything about Brittany Renner, she played soccer. And here's another post of her, just so you can see her out there doing her thing or whatever. And she went back to JSU. I had a clip of her going back to JSU, but I decided to forego that clip because it really didn't add any more to the narrative or the story of what's really happening now. But I wanted to, I guess what I was going to get at is that she has an affinity for her university, for her alma mater. So she went back for homecoming. You can see people love her, maybe because she's famous. I don't know if that's why, but clearly they had some love for her. And with her going through this situation, Deion Sanders used this as an opportunity, as a moment, as a learning moment. And so what he did was he brought her back. And this is what we got. Here's a few clips from her visit to speak with the football team. Now she's experienced. Y'all remember this when you watch it.
Yourself and let's go from step A to Z, because we got to kind of show these guys the other side,
right,
of game. And that's mm-hmm. why you gracefully blessed us with your presence, so they could understand from your point of view how this game is played.
So my name is Brittany Renner, aka Bundle of Brittany on Instagram. Mm-hmm. I have been on social media from
your game took notes all year, but now you want to. And that's how the game starts, with the phone.
Right.
They go on Instagram, and they see you. And what happens? They try to get off in them DMs. And kind of take us on the journey of how this is played out.
I mean, honey, like, I feel like my DMs, it's like a Nike store. There's nothing but checks. So it just, for me, I feel like
Hold on. They missed that game.
Nothing but blue checks.
They missed that game right there. She says like a Nike store.
It's like a Nike store. There's nothing but blue checks. So honestly, when you reach a certain status, you can have the pick of the litter. So for me.
She don't mean checks, paper. She mean blue checks.
I'm talking heavy hitters. Some of y'all's favorite rappers, NBA players, football players. It's like, to me, once you reach that level just of popularity, the world is your oyster. You can do whatever you want. And for me, my whole journey on here, I felt like my life almost felt like I was in Disney World, like I lived in Disney World. Like, you get to skip the line. You get privilege. Like, people just want to be next to you. They don't even see you as human anymore. And you can either, you know, use it to your advantage and maybe abuse it, or you can, you know, try to make something happen. So a lot of guys who are in my DM, you're in my DM because I'm Brittany Renner. So naturally, if you play a sport, it's kind of like, well, that's an incentive to talk to you. A lot of times, women, men in general, everybody wants something.
Thank you.
Everybody wants something. So it's like, even if we both have our own thing going on, me still being with you is a good look because you boost my stock. Just like you boost my, you know what I'm saying? Like, I boost your stock. It's just that simple. It's kind of like a give and take, but you have to be aware of what you're signing up for. You're trying to, you want to make it to the NFL, and it's kind of like, you do understand there's a lot that comes with that, right? There's gonna, like, how, it's, to be able to decipher who really loves you for you, I think that's like the billion-dollar question we're all wanting to know.
This is how the game is played. Please know that. We're putting you up on game, because some of y'all gonna make it. I hope, pray all of y'all make it, even if you make it in the business world. That's a whole nother category of game. In that world too, they just dress it up a little different.
Yeah.
The game is the same. Only thing changed is y'all names.
Yeah.
That's the stuff I just spit right there.
You are useful, and it's better to be useful than useless. So you just have to have that understanding that, okay, I have something to offer, you know, whether that's financial, status-wise, whatever. And people do see that as a bonus to be with you. There's nothing wrong with that, because you both, like, both of you can have stuff going on, but you just have to be aware nobody is just here for nothing. It's just about figuring out who could be there during the times of adversity. And you would only know that going through adversity. Like, if you had an injury and you weren't able to play, or just for even a short amount of time, like, there are just certain things you're going to have to just see for yourself. Well,
the game is the same. The names just change. Woo.
Yeah.
That's a good quotable right there, Deion. Deion said that one. The game is the same. The only thing that changes is the name. What do you think about that clip, Alona Boo? Her coming back to JSU, talking to the football players. Did she give them some game, or did I don't? Because I don't know. Did she give them?
I feel like she did, and this is why. Because, you know, okay, I'm a woman, but I don't know exactly how men think. You know, like I have an idea of how I think that you guys think. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, especially like a professional athlete or something like that. You know, I think they feel like, you know, like, oh, I got money. I got influence. You know what I'm saying? I can prove how I want to. I can get the baddest bitch. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. So that's how I think an athlete thinks. So, but it's different if I get an actual athlete in front of me telling me exactly how he thinks. You know what I'm saying? So in this case, you take, you know, some guys who, let's be honest, are specifically gonna go if they make this, you know, the NFL and do all that kind of stuff. Even if they don't quite make the NFL, but let's say they, you know, known locally, you know, for being, you know.
Oh, yeah, they was the college superstar
or
something
like that. College superstars or whatever. They are already starting this social media process.
Right.
You're already following the influence, the big booty Instagram models, the, you know what I'm saying, like all that. You're already, so you have your plot in your head, because let's be honest, in most cases, the men want to get in the panties, the women want to get in the pockets.
So it's either the panties or the pockets for the players.
And you know what I'm saying? And that's what
on both sides.
On both sides. So you got something I want, and I got something you want.
Right. And let's she said honest. It. Right.
That's the basis of any relationship. Right. You know what I'm saying? Because ain't nobody going into no relationship not wanting something.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I want love. I want happiness. I want, you know, either financial stability. I want, you know what I'm saying? I want a family. I, you know what I'm saying? Like, whatever it is, we're all entering into relationships wanting something.
Right.
So when it comes to what she was doing, I feel like she was putting them on game and saying, look, as the woman that you're going to be salivating over.
Oh, I see what you're saying. I see the reverse happening a lot. Go ahead.
You see what I'm saying? Like, as I'm the woman that you're going to want to get to know.
Right. I'm the blue check.
I'm the one with the blue check. I'm the one with 4 million followers. I'm the one that can get, you know what I'm saying, your hottest rapper, your, you know, your whoever, your, you know what I'm saying, your NFL player, your NBA player. I'm that chick. Mm-hmm. So I'm sitting here finna tell you, as that chick, this is how the game is played. You know what I'm saying? You want to get in my panties. You want to be able to say you bagged me.
Right.
You want some of my 4 million followers to now follow you. So you can get that blue check if you ain't already got
it. The influence of the influencer. Yeah. I see what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying? So like she said, it's a come up on both sides. I raise your stock, you raise my stock.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, she's sitting there telling you, I'm the one that you want, and this is how I'm going to play the game. You know,
and you know she's the one, because when she walked in,
crowd went crazy. You know what I'm saying? You notice the outfit she wore.
Yeah, I know she I wearing a lot of nude stuff.
It's
is that called nude? That's called nude, right? The colors?
Yeah, it's kind of like it's in the nude family, that color she wore. But you know what I'm saying? It's almost like, I don't know if it was Skims, but it's you know, something extremely form fitting. There's something that basically leaves nothing to the imagination.
Yeah, you can see the butt. You can see the butt, the breast, and the box.
You can see it all.
All three B's. You know what I'm saying? That's why she called her bundles of breasts. It's a butt, box, and breast. You see all of it.
This is still a hide your sons moment.
Yeah. If you try to hide, they're going to come out.
Yeah, she ain't coming none of that. She, you know what I'm saying? She came, you know, like she came, and she dresses like that a lot, you know what I'm saying? To show off the curves and all that kind of stuff, because she is who she is, and that's what she does. So, you know what I'm saying? So if you sit here and got somebody, it's like this. If I want to learn about finances, who am I going to go to? I'm not going to go to my homie who ain't got no money, who ain't doing nothing. You know what I'm saying? With nothing like that, I'm going to go seek a financial advisor because I need to know your opinion. How does this work? You know what I'm saying? So, and this is the same situation. So if I want to know how this game is played, especially if I want to know from the woman's perspective how this game is played, then you bring in somebody who has played the game.
Right.
And she's going to sit here and tell you, and I didn't hear no lies. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be hard to decipher who is for you, right, and who's just for you to see what you can do for them.
Who's for you to get that bag, that pay?
Yeah, who, you know what I'm saying? And the higher you get on that totem pole, the harder it is to figure this shit out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
saying? Yeah.
Because, you know, you get washed up in, like she said, in the privilege and the access, you know, and all that kind of stuff. And then the lines get blurred. You think because, you know what I'm saying, oh, they cool, they got a blue check, you know what I'm saying? Or we get money together, they for me. No, they for themselves first. Mm-hmm.
They for keeping that blue check blue.
Exactly. And if you do something, please believe, if you do something that's going to jeopardize any of that for them.
Right, right.
They
right.
out.
They out. And I wonder if that's what even happened with her with PJ Washington. Like, why did he cheat on her? Why did he sleep around on her? What did whatever he did that made her want to be like, I got to be out? You know,
I believe, because in one of the articles I read, it was kind of like alluded to that he cheated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's mm-hmm. that's why she starts in another video. She referenced lying.
Yeah.
Like that he cheated right. and he lied.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, and that's why she's like, there's repercussions if yeah. you're going to be a liar.
Right.
So prepare for those repercussions.
Well, she also talked about that in the Dove's Cry interview, where she basically said, because she, part of what why she was doing the interview was because of some of the rhetoric that Kevin Samuels has that she wanted to challenge, which was like high value men being able to exercise their options. She said, it's the exercising their options part for me that yeah. I can't get with. And she said, not because it's not true, but because there's so many men who are not high value who take that as, oh, I can cheat. And I understood what she was saying that it should be clarified that, you know, that is a thing for a certain class of men. But what she didn't take into account is, who does Kevin Samuels classify as high value?
Exactly.
Because he will say, I don't consider entertainers, athletes, musicians, even though they may make a lot of money, I don't consider them high value. Because there is there's dime, dignity, integrity. He has a whole like list of things that you gotta have when you high value. So that's number one. Number two, if that is not what the agreement is coming into it, you know what I mean, then that needs to be made clear. But what happens is that you must understand that when men make money, they are going to have some options that are going to, especially if they are known or they're at the top of their game. They're going to have some options that are going to come to them. And you must make a decision as a woman who's getting with that kind of man on how you need to approach what is available to him.
Yeah.
Because there's men that go out and they seek to cheat. And then there's this men where it just comes. They ain't got to do nothing.
Right.
They got to seek. They ain't got to seek a new relationship. The girl knocking on the door. As soon as you walk out, she's ready to walk in.
Exactly.
And I think that's one of the things that he was trying to explain to her, you know, in her situation. You know, is that, you know, did you consider these things, like the availability of women around somebody who has a multi-million dollar contract in the industry, in the basketball industry? And on the other side of that, what everybody said that she was going to do with the situation after leaving him, she has not done yet. I mean, there was rumors of her getting a settlement for $200,000 a month child support. That's like $40 million over 18 years. That nigga ain't got $40 million.
No.
So that's not even in the realm of reality that even happened. You know what I mean? But from the video I showed you guys on the aftermath, we see that to the contrary. She had to move out, move in with mama.
Mm-hmm.
She ain't gonna find her own place. Mm-hmm. She ain't had no car.
Yep.
So what it glitters like gold might not be what you think it is.
And that's what I was saying earlier. Like, I think, like I said, when the grass ain't always greener, like you initially think,
yeah.
you know what I'm saying? You know, you see, like I said, you got your plan, yeah. but they always say, tell God your plans and watch him laugh. Because that's what you thought it was going to be.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But when you get in that situation and the person, you know what I'm saying, doesn't want to pull their weight, or, you know what I'm saying, or they actually don't end up financially supporting you like you thought you was going to do, and now you right. stuck with a whole baby.
You stuck with a whole baby. Take care of for 18 months. Maybe they didn't even want to be with you. Maybe they wanted to be with all these other women. You was just a step along the ladder. They want to shoot the club up of Brittany Renner.
Yeah.
I mean, they wanted to be able to, like, I shot her club. I put it all up in her. You and I was successful because she got pregnant. Mm-hmm. They may have wanted to say that. Maybe you never know why their reason for getting her to do that. Right.
Got, you know, sort of twisted motives of, you know, about, you know, why they do what they do.
Which is why you should get the ring first. If you think this is your guy, why do you now follow the model that you told the other women to follow?
Exactly.
When, if that's your guy, why not get the ring first? Exactly. So I think she was a good person to bring back, because I think a lot of times we look at somebody who's failed as someone who shouldn't be speaking to about their failure. I think that's wrong. I think it's perfectly right to have her come speak about it.
Yeah.
Because she went all the way through the process. And people gave, I think they were giving Deion Sanders some pushback about inviting her. And I'm thinking, no, that is in college. And if you don't know, so if you haven't gone to college, in college, you have a distinguished lecture series. Sometimes you have guest speakers, you know, guest lecturers. And in this case, to me, that fits the bill for especially for athletes, right? These are gentlemen who are in an athletics program in a higher education, in a higher institution of education. So this kind of opportunity to meet a practitioner of what they're going to experience when they get into the world. Because, you know, you get a lot of professors in college.
Exactly.
But for me, him bringing Brittany back, that's like having a practitioner come in who has done the work, has had the business, has built the bridge, in this case, has fucked the athlete, got pregnant by the athlete, had the baby, like you said, been through the whole nine, to say to them, this is what it's going to be. Do you want that baggage?
Exactly.
You looking at the baggage. I look good, don't I? You want to fuck right now, don't you? You know what I'm saying? That's how she came in there looking like let me look like my body so you can see what it is.
And you can tell, like, by their reaction, you know what I'm saying? I just wish we knew, like, how many of them slid into her DM even after she
afterwards,
said what she
even,
said. Like,
even after she, cause you know, those ignorant motherfuckers. Let me. So she said, blue check, right?
Right. Okay. She said bundles check. Of Brittany, right?
Bundles? like a bundle, or like a dozen of Britneys, or like a bundle of Britney, or like a handful of Brit? A handful of Brit? Is that a handful of Britney? A bevy of Britneys. A bevy of Britneys. I'm going to give a bevy. Spell bevy. Bevy. You know, like... They was up in there. You know, some of them niggas still hit her up.
Yes.
And I wondered, did she take him to the... Okay, lesson number two.
Here we go.
There's a date. I got to figure out the name of this date for in another episode when we start talking about dating again. I got to figure out this name for this type of date when women take a man up on a date just for food. Oh, God. Because there's this thing where, you know, women, they would just say yes to a date just to get fed.
Yeah, free food.
They had a cool little clever name for it. I forget what. If you guys know it, put it in the comments below. I need to remember that name, that clever name for it. It's not a food date or something like that. It's like a foodie or something like that. But it's a clever little name. But essentially, like, literally, that's what she just did. Like, even so, she had no money at all. Five of them niggas who going to spend their mama a little money they gave them to go to college with to take her ass out. And she might say yes. Okay, he's breakfast, he's lunch, he's dinner. Mm-hmm. Who's tomorrow? Oh, and can I get some to go?
Exactly.
I need to puree this for my baby.
For my baby.
You know, and it's funny because I actually have seen or I've heard of a situation where a woman went on a date with a guy and asked, would you mind buying another plate so I can take it home to my kids? So for to go. I wonder, was that even appropriate to do? Which I thought it wasn't, but it was kind of interesting because the fact that she asked means either she was bold or somebody has done it before.
Yeah.
So, It's good. I mean,
but sometimes people just testing the waters to see exactly how much they can get out of you.
I want to see how far you'll go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we know, for example, like men, especially men, mm-hmm. like no offense to y'all, mm-hmm, but mm-hmm. y'all will go pretty far.
Some simp dudes? For some simp. Oh, listen, well, it's because simping is doing stuff for a woman so she could be nice to you, right? Being nice to a woman. I don't know. I think there are some men who will do everything up to pay for the pussy. And don't get me wrong, I was saying this to somebody one day. I was like, actually, technically, we all pay for the pussy.
Exactly. Right?
It don't matter if you simp it or not, because you, who's to say the time I spent with a non-simp in a non-simpy way, where we went on the first date, went Dutch, you know, went on the second date, you know what I'm saying, went Dutch, went on the third date, I paid, I'm liking her now, went on the fourth date, okay, now she's with me, all right, now we together, now we getting married, you know what I'm saying, I'm taking care of everything. Who's to say that process is no different than the guy who went to the strip club and told the stripper, I'll pay a bill if you come on with me?
Right.
What's the difference? You know what I mean? Other than he got to the pussy first.
Right.
That was a quick transaction.
He just took the direct route.
Right. Where the other one, the clock got burned, his wallet got burned.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, y'all paying in some kind of way. Yeah. But there are some things where you're just getting you're doing a little too much. You know, you're doing too much, man. You're dressing the kids' room up with LED lights for Christmas and shit. You done bought the LEDs. You helping them move out the house.
Yeah.
And shit. Y'all ain't even claiming each other, but, you know, I mean, you hoping to get back to the... Or you feel obligated because she done gave you some pussy on the first night and you weren't thinking that was going to happen. So now you feel like you got to do... You need me to pick that up for you? Your laundry? I'll get the laundry for you. Like, you turn into a servant. Like, they turn into a servant instantly. Mm-hmm. She must have whipped that nigga good. So, you know, you never know. You know, as we do our 1 hour warning, I always want to make sure I tell the Instagram family goodbye just in case y'all drop. They see y'all still live, but just in case you drop 1 hour warning, you know what it is.
A warning.
Hey, it may drop y'all, but hang in there to a dude. But we love you if you don't, you know, if it don't last. But yeah, so yeah, you don't want to do all the extra stuff. Not to say that you don't, if you, whoever you are, you want to be yourself, but you know, you ain't got to be all extra nice to these women. These women ain't, you know, you can treat them regular, you know what I'm saying? Treat them regular and keep it moving. The problem is that you got to understand what comes with a woman of that status. When you are of status as a man and you are an athlete out here doing your thing and the groupies are coming your way, you got to understand that if you don't wrap it up, just sex can turn into 18 years of headache.
Clank, clank.
Yeah. It could be worse. I mean, she could hit that man up for some child support and his pay grade is going to be a little different.
Yep.
It's going to be a little different. To help maintain that child's lifestyle.
Lifestyle.
Right? So, you got to be careful out here. I think what they did, you know, I know they're giving Deion a little flack, but I think Deion Sanders did a good job bringing her there. I think that was actually, this forum hopefully will lead to more things. Like, I know that more forums like this. I know it helps that she went to Jackson State so that she has some kind of tie to the school coming back. But, man, really, they should get some of the bigger ones. Like you know, I don't know if you consider Brittany a thought box. I've said this on shows before. I actually used to like Brittany back in the day. Like, I used to like the stuff that she was doing. I really liked her movement, liked where she was going. And something, I can't pinpoint, something she did just kind of made me go, I ain't following her no more. You know, I don't know if it was her going into this realm of stuff that made me do it, but it was a while. I just stopped following her. But I thought she was a beautiful woman, but she still is. And I really thought she was probably going to make it a little bit bigger in Hollywood as an actress. And maybe she needed more motivation or direction in that. But, I mean, I stopped following her, and I find it interesting that this is the direction she has gone. Hopefully, she does find her guy.
Yeah.
Her guy forever. But it's going to be a little tougher now for her because, you know, now
it's
you got...
It's going to be tougher.
You got bundles of bags now.
Because now she's been labeled, you know, a thot, a gold digger, You know what I'm saying? All the stuff that you don't want to be labeled as, you know, as a woman, especially, you know, in this industry amongst people.
Right.
But it ain't gonna stop nothing. Because there's still gonna be some people that still slide her DMs, you know what I'm saying? Because it's all about the aesthetic, you know what I'm saying?
Right. She's
aesthetically pleasing. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then she is, like I said, she does have the over four million followers.
Mm-hmm.
She's verified. You know what I'm saying? So it's still gonna be some people that's still gonna slide in them DMs. So you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna say it's totally hopeless for her, nothing like that. It is gonna be a little bit more difficult because some dudes just see it as a challenge to just hit now.
Yeah, I mean them DMs, which you don't know.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Not that wasn't the goal at first. You know what I'm saying? But you know, it's, you know, because people, some guys see that as just, oh, it's a challenge. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Oh, I can tame her, you know what I'm saying, or whatever the case may be.
And it happens like that. It does happen like that. So, you know, I really just think that, you know, it's just one of those things where we just need to understand what the game is and know that the game has been around for a long time. And you ain't going to do nothing new that ain't been done already. Your name just different.
This
is a new player.
This game been played.
And they going to keep playing it.
Exactly.
They're going to keep playing. So understand what it is.
Biblical days this game was played. So
prostitution. I think prostitution is the oldest career.
That sounds about right.
I think you can look that up. Y'all look that up. I think prostitution is the oldest form of work or oldest career, something like that. Which is crazy because that means women been working before the men was working.
Working it.
Ah, emoji. Working it. She said, working it.
Yes.
Yeah. But listen, man, it seems we got way too many feelings about Brittany Renner.
Too many feelings.
Actually, we ain't got too many feelings. Maybe Busy Bone got too many feelings. Why he threw the
Busy Bone got way too many.
He got way too many. I mean, I don't know what's wrong. Why that man still acting like that? I don't understand.
Somebody shouted out. You didn't take your pill today, huh?
He showed, that was a, what's her name? Is it Gangsta Boo?
Gangsta Boo.
Yeah. She shouted out, Disney, take his pill. He ain't take his pills today, man. He gonna ruin y'all career. You know how to get rid of him.
Right.
Maybe that's the reason why we ain't really heard from him a whole lot, you know? Maybe that's the reason why.
Maybe.
You know, and shout out to Deion Sanders, shout out to Jackson State University's football team, the Tigers. Doing their thing. Shout out to Brittany Renner for coming through for her alma mater and bringing the game to them. The game that they haven't played right yet. You know, so she bringing them the game. And Versus and 3-6, Bone Thugs, everybody. Shout out to you, Alona Boo. You know what I'm saying? For soldiering through. You know, I know you weren't feeling well this past week. I appreciate you for showing up today. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all, we got my little sniffles and my cough. So
you see what I got. Look, why you playing? Look, a nose. Look, why you need?
And why you
these puffs indeed? Don't you know the commercial? A nose in need needs puffs. I just advertise. I'm sorry, puff. Send me a check.
I'm on the Kleenex squad.
Send me a check, puffs. Damn, a nose in need. You heard the quote. I said it. You know. Hey, listen. It's been rough, man. You know, we got that Delta Omicron circulating.
Man, y'all keep yourself careful.
Be careful. Mask up.
Mask back up, cause it's real out here.
Yeah, double up on your booster. Get one booster, then go get another. No, I was playing.
I got my booster and my flu shot all in the same damn day.
Listen,
I ain't playing. Like I'm playing, and I still caught a damn cold. So I still, you know, what I'm saying, like it's hard out here. Like I'm gonna say, I'm staying masked up, like for real.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want no more shit. I hate being sick.
That's what I'm saying. That song got a new meaning. They talking about mask off. I'm like, mask off.
No, mask
up. Right. You know, that song got new meaning. But yeah, I hope everybody's doing well. I hope everybody had a good Thanksgiving out there. You know, this is, you know, we're getting out of 2021, going to 2022. Man, let's just hope that we can get rid of this COVID and not take this into another year.
Another variant.
Right, 2020. Really, it's COVID-19
because it started
in December of COVID of 2019.
Yeah.
So really, the whole of 2020, the whole of 2021, that's dos years.
Dos.
That's dos. We don't want to do this three times over, y'all.
Those onions.
Mask up, y'all. Please. Please mask up. If y'all watch this, mask up. Let's get to a place where we get back to getting together without having to wear a mask. I probably still gonna wear a mask a lot just because, like, I feel like, you know, I ain't trying to get sick.
Yeah, so. I ain't trying to get sick with none of it. COVID, the flu, the damn common cold, pneumonia. The mask protects you against a lot of shit. Bad breath.
Right. Nigga spitting on your face. It's so much more offensive now.
Rogue
sneezes. It was already offensive.
You don't want to walk into nobody's knees like that. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, God. Mm-mm. Just smell like breath. Oh, my. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm stopping.
Yeah, sneezes do smell like breath.
Oh, my God. Oh, I can't even think about it no more. Look. Okay. Y'all, like, subscribe, hit the bell icon so you get notified when we drop new episodes. Y'all, our handles are in the description below. You know, tell us how you feel. I've been here with...
Hey, it's your girl, Alona Boo. I'm in the building. I might got a cold, but it's all good because I'm going to bounce back.
You about to bounce back.
I'm about to bounce back, okay?
Listen, and I'm yours truly, T Staples. And make sure you catch us next time when we all... discover how many feelings we got. We all have too many feelings.
We got too many.
Peace.